So how many of you have watched 1920? Yeah, right. So you might be knowing that it takes place in a pre-independence time. And in that, the main character wants to get married with an Anglo-Indian, right? Who is part British. Now the main character's own family does not agree with this. And here we see an interesting commentary on how we still impose all these strict boundaries. You know, we might be thinking that we live in a world where there is no racism, no sexism, but still it exists in a much subtler form. And through the medium of horror, we see how they manifest in various ways. For example, even the movie Get Out, which came out last year, showed that how we might think we live in a post-racism world, but it still exists in many ways. So you see, horror gets away with with asking you bold questions which you may not like confronting, which you may not like answering, and it gives you a strong opinion which you can think about later. So not only is horror allowing you to enjoy, it is also giving you food for thought. You can go home and think, is this really good? Is mob justice good? And all that. So that is another another way in which it is very effective. And last but not the least, I feel, is that horror is a very effective way of communicating philosophy. So when I came across this, even I was, astonished. Horror and philosophy, they seem poles apart. But actually, through the medium of horror, the grotesque transformations and all, one can often put forward all these thoughts and, get across their feelings, which makes the person think about how they actually live their life. First of all, it makes you stop taking your time for life for granted.